sun beats on my back as I gaze upon the unseen wind. And there you are, wandering, whispering wisdom that's eternal, from the heart to the mind, to the hand, to the journal. Now the kernel of the seed in the cleft of the rock, and it's watered by the winds having power to unlock. Stop the clock of chronological logic with its homogenized systems that it better can't dodge. Cause the depth of the voice of an almighty one.
The first time that I came here to Nicaragua, I fell in love with the people. I couldn't speak Spanish at the time, so it was very frustrating. It planted a desire in me to learn Spanish, take Spanish in school, and to come back and really develop those relationships with people instead of just saying, hey, what's up, and then never seeing them again.
The main purpose was to teach Ultimate to these kids. I told them that if he wanted to make this trip happen, that I really wanted to be a part of it. Because language barrier or not, it's always a thrill to teach and to spread Ultimate.
I came up with the idea to use it as a community development project in the village that I've been working on in the last 6 years. And because there's so many issues in that village, and sports play a huge, huge role for these people.
This is a culture that's very soccer driven. We really wanted to kind of lend certain soccer terms and movements and such to the Ultimate drills that we would show them. In particular, one that seemed to really be a hit for them was basically we put them 12 yards away from the goal, and we said, you know, out of 5 throws, how many backhands can you put in the goal? And then how many flicks can you put in the goal? And then we moved them 5 yards back and said, okay, can you do the same thing? How many out of 5 can you do? And that was a big hit for them because it was just like practicing your penalty kicks in soccer.
We started off with just the most basic things. Day one was just a lot of throwing and catching. Frisbee is one of those sports that is very hard for the average person to just start playing. You have to have some basics in order to do it. We practiced the backhand for a couple drills, then the flick. We eventually moved on to what's called a diamond drill, where they throw it and then run, and then the person from the other line runs over and does the same thing.
When they did the diamond drill, at first it was really hard for them to grasp. They didn't grasp the tempo of it, they didn't grasp the simple mechanics of it, and it was a little bit of a battle for us, whereas, you know, again, for us it's so simple, to for them it was much more of a push-pull kind of thing until we got them to settle into it. Once they settled into it, they enjoyed it much more and they got something out of it.
Tournament was definitely a success. We got 3-4 solid games in. It was awesome. Kids are running hard. We had a couple of the guys even laying out and making some bids for the disc, which was awesome to see. The catching is where I noticed the biggest difference throughout the whole trip. As the days progressed, those are the kids that got involved. Like, they would be full speed sprinting, run up, jump, and catch it. Their coordination and just ability to play the sport just dramatically increased just because of their catching.
What was really cool was to be able to see the kids that we taught during the week how to throw, teaching the other kids that were new how to throw and how to play the game and explaining the rules and seeing them actually understand how to play. That to us was awesome, to be able to see just what after a couple of days could do. There was kids that were 3 feet tall, you know, that were beating kids that were 6 feet tall because they understood the game. They practiced more and they cared more about it. So it was very cool to see that and see the development after just 3 or 4 days.
Siempre estamos unidos y que aprendemos más cada día.
Me gusta el fútbol y también me gusta el frisbee porque nos vinieron a mostrar cómo se jugaba. Uh-huh. Entonces, también este es uno de mis deportes preferidos.
Tengo varios deportes favoritos. Me gusta jugar en, algunas veces el fútbol, me gusta más voleibol, y ahora que me gusta este deporte que lo estoy practicando, que es frisbee, ahora sí tengo oportunidades para practicarlo con ustedes. Pero antes no estaba muy interesado porque no conocía muy bien el juego.
Bueno, mi deporte favorito son varios. Está el fútbol, está el baloncesto. Y pues ahora estoy aprendiendo este nuevo juego que estamos aprendiendo aquí, que es el frisbee. Pues me gusta como la manera de lanzar, me gusta la pasión con que se juega el partido.
I keep coming back to Nicaragua because the first time I came here, I just had a passion for these people, for the poverty, the needs that are here, and I want to do something about it.
If I could describe this country, I would say that it's a very pure place. There's so much like beautiful landscape and all the mountains. It's beautiful to see. I enjoy this place.
The major problems that I see in Los Cedros are no different than they are in the States. They're just on a grander scale because they don't have unemployment, they don't have other things to aid them when they're not working. Laziness is huge. The men who do work are few and far between. The women have really stepped up over the last couple of years and are going to Managua working for the week, and they're coming back at night or coming back on the weekend to take care of the family.
Una familia que tiene 8 miembros, ahí está el papá, la mamá y los hijos, y tal vez tienen una casa muy pequeñita y tal vez tienen 3 camas por decir camas, pero a veces no son camas, son hamacas, son otras formas que nosotros llamamos tijeras, y ahí en esas 3 se acomodan todos. Entonces eso como que baja la estima del matrimonio, de los jóvenes, de los niños. Y hay mucho descuido porque nosotros atendemos mucha consejería de los niños, cómo asimilan las actitudes de los adultos por eso, porque todos están juntos en una pequeña casa y con pocas camas. Ese es un problema moral.
I think some problems in the community are obviously just poverty, just not having anything, but also just the lack of leadership from the males. They see other things as higher priorities than providing for the family.
Otro problema moral es el vicio en los padres, ¿verdad? El padre quizás es vicioso, decimos nosotros, pero borracho, muy fuerte, tal vez que maltrata a la mamá, maltrata a los hijos. Entonces, ese es otro problema moral. Otro problema de lo que es espiritual es de que el padre y la madre mandan a los niños a las iglesias, mandan a los niños a saber del Señor, pero ellos no asisten, ellos dicen que...
Yo antes, de la edad de 11 años, varios amigos que solo en eso vivían, de mi edad, eran ambiciosos, fumaban, bebían. Y igual yo también una vez lo probé. Pero desde que comencé a la iglesia, ya eso.
Que sus niños necesitan de Dios, pero que ellos no. Y en cuanto a la salud, igual la salud aquí no. Si vamos a un centro de asistencia médica, están los doctores, están las enfermeras, pero no se hallan los medicamentos, están las recetas. Y la gente no tiene dinero para comprarle la medicina, está muy cara.
other problems, kids obviously getting in trouble with drugs, sex, crime, because there's nothing much to do besides you go to school, or if they don't go to school and they don't have a job, then hey, what am I gonna do, you know? And the options are minimal, but if they have another choice, another sport, or another thing to pass the time with, then maybe that can minimize, you know, some of these other options that aren't as beneficial.
En cuanto a lo económico, los salarios son, no son mínimos. Los salarios son, aquí se les dice en Nicaragua, salarios de hambre, porque es poquísimo, no, no, ni siquiera para una semana ajusta la familia. Porque si hoy le pagan al trabajador su salario, ya el trabajador a los días ya no tiene dinero. No porque tal vez lo mal administre, sino porque son salarios, como les vuelvo a decir, de hambre. Salarios solamente para entretenernos, pero que sí, nosotros lo aceptamos porque no tenemos otra salida. Y bueno, ya les mencioné la salud, lo espiritual, lo moral y lo laboral. Bien, entonces, otro problema es de que a veces no tienen un terreno, no tienen una casa las familias, y en un espacio tienen que vivir hasta tres familias. Tres, dos familias, a veces vive la suegra, todos los hijos con la nuera y que está casado. Y eso es igual. Hay mucho, a veces muchas inconformidades, muchas incomodidades, porque no hay privacidad en las familias. Sí.
Pues por aquí en esta comunidad de Los Cedros no hay muchas oportunidades de poder recrearse los chavales, los muchachos, porque casi no hay cancha donde jugar, pues se necesita más, por decir, el parque para que la gente se recree, y es lo que falta aquí. Si no hay deporte aquí, pues la mayoría de las personas se refugia en las diferentes producciones que existen aquí.
Lo que pueden hacer para divertirse es ir a las canchas de la comunidad. Aquí, la mayoría de todos van ahí. Antes no había cancha y la mayoría de los muchachos solo caminaban en las calles fumando o buscando droga o cosas así. Yo quiero ver aquí, quiero ver un cambio total. Quiero que toda la comunidad cambie, que las calles no sean de tierra, que sean pavimentadas. Que construyan un campo deportivo más grande y jugar y recrearse sanamente, y que mis hijos vayan y se diviertan.
Latsudeka is the city dump. It basically, just like it sounds, the trash gets dumped in there by all the dump trucks. That's where they take it from the city of Managua. It's just outside the city. And when I first got here, it was hard to drive through. The streets were flooded with trash. If you didn't have a 4x4, it was very difficult to get through there without getting stuck. Basically, the most powerful story I've heard about it, and the best way to describe it, is that people in there are so desperate that when they, like, if you have a better piece of trash than I do, then I would give you my daughter for the night just so I can dig through your piece of trash. And so I think that was really the biggest thing that hit home for me about how, like, poor and desperate these families are. I've seen people dig through bags of old Tip Top, which is like a KFC around here, just trying to scrounge stuff off the chicken wings, that the gristle that's still on there left from people smelling coleslaw to see if it's still edible. It's just a very sad situation, very dark, very poor place. It also has a little school in the dump that kind of brings a little light of hope for these kids and gets them out of the dump, gets them out of digging through trash for a little bit. And so that's a very positive impact in a very dark community. Now it's changing. The Spanish government has come in and started to kick people out and clean it up, which on the outside it looks great, but just worried about the people that they're kicking out, and they're moving to other places that they don't know anything else but the dump. So it'll be interesting to see in the next couple of years how that pans out, to see whether it's really a positive impact or negative. Dun, dun, dun.
I think it'll have a positive effect on the community because it'll give them something else to do. To give them another sport that they can play fairly easily when they just need a frisbee in a field, just like soccer, I feel like it'll give them another option. Because we gave them frisbees, they had them in their house, and so when they're walking out their door, the idea is, oh, there's a frisbee there, there's a disc, we can go play that. When they're bored, hey, what can we do? I don't feel like playing soccer, let's play ultimate. Because the disc is very easy just to pick up, you and another person just throw. You can throw for 10 minutes, you can throw for an hour over conversation.
I think it can have a very positive effect on the community just based on the fact that if you have a plastic frisbee and you have a field that's open enough to put some people on it, you can play for as long as you want to, as long as the sun is up. I think the results are very varied. We had a couple of the older kids who, while very athletically talented, were also on the lazier side, mainly because they didn't grasp it right away. On the flip side, we had younger kids who we didn't even truly intend to work with at the time, who excelled very, very well. I had a kid who I kind of favored over the week because he had a very strong work ethic. He was 14 years old, and all he wanted to do was drill himself to get better. And then on the second, third, and fourth days of our clinics, I watched him teach other kids the same things that I had shown him on the first day, about how to move his hands the right way, how to catch properly. You know, he had started to grasp those things. So there are some of the kids, especially on the younger side, where I think they are more committed to taking the lessons that we've shown them and applying them throughout the time to come.
I want to believe that it'll definitely help the community. I feel like I made a change in some of those kids, so it was awesome.
There's definitely a couple kids out there who seem like leaders that were really into it, and hopefully they take it and encourage the kids to keep playing, because I think it's definitely a good sport, and if anything, it's just a nice break from soccer for them. I think it will definitely have a positive impact on the community. Some of those kids out there, just seeing the way they dressed and seeing them wear the same exact clothes all 4 days they were out there shows how tough times are in that village. Frisbee is one of those sports that all they need is a disc to play, really. And there's hundreds of frisbees floating around that village now, so I hope they'd have no problem finding one to play. Hopefully this kind of teaches them sportsmanship, and with the whole spirit of the game thing we taught them, it just teaches them some good life values and keeps them off the street a little more too.
I think it's going to definitely positively impact the community. They don't get to have a lot of people come in and organize sporting events or organize anything in that community, so it's nice to have people come in and do something positive for them, provide something for them, give back to the community, and also provide an outlet for them to play, to run around, and to not get in trouble.
Ya más personas pueden estar más interesadas en este deporte y pueden pasar el tiempo jugando de eso y olvidarse de cosas malas, cosas sin provecho que hacían antes. Así pueden, no sé, andar en la calle, algunos fumando o conseguir drogas, cosas así. Mejor el deporte sano y dejar las cosas malas.
Bueno, me gustaría para mí que se desarrolle más lo que es estas uniones de diferentes países con compartir las culturas extranjeras, a ir a compartirlas con los nicaragüenses, porque por ejemplo este juego del frisbee aquí no se sabe jugar, y es importante cómo saber este juego que viene del extranjero, pues nosotros cómo lo venimos a aceptando, y pues creo que es una mano. Y otra cosa, pues no sé, implementaron más cosas como lugar donde recrearse, una cancha, parque de recreación, sería muy bueno para que la juventud se inserte más en lo que es el deporte.
Will this sport progress here? Yes. Will it happen slowly? Maybe not as quickly as we'd like it to? Yeah, the sky's the limit here, but we really have to work harder at engaging everybody. And I think when we can do that, we'll be very successful.